Good morning, everyone. Welcome to worship this morning. We're going to start things off with a song. We will have the words up on the screen and invite you to please sing along with us. This first one is called My Hope Is In You.
It is so wonderful to have you with us at First Lutheran Church in Greensboro, North Carolina. I am Pastor Emily Lemoyne, one of the pastors here, and it's a wonderful day to worship and to be together, whether you are here in person or at home. I only have one announcement I want to bring to your attention, and some of you have already done it. We have a faith formation survey that we would really like for you to take so we know what we are going to be able to offer this fall, what your expectations are, what your hopes are for faith formation this fall. So please take a moment, look back on the Thursday e-news. There should be a link. Click on it. It takes about 2 minutes to fill it out, but it gives us really, really valuable information that we are using as we are planning and proceeding for plans for this fall. So take a moment and do that. That's it, but you know, if you read the e-news, there are lots of other ways that you can find to get connected in the life and ministry here, so go back and read through that. There's lots of valuable information. And so as our service continues, what better way to start service than with Piglet and Pooh? Winnie the Pooh was one of my absolute favorite when I was little, and when I found this quote, I thought it was just absolutely appropriate. Piglet questions, how do you spell love? And think about when you've been around kids and they want to know how to spell things, right? So he's expecting that Pooh is just going to turn around and say L-O-V-E. But Pooh turns around and says, you don't spell it, you feel it. I want you to think about that. Love is not just a word. It's a feeling, right? And you can't describe it. You can't explain it. You know, when you see little kids and, you know, they're playing love, or, you know, teenage love. And teenagers go, well, how do you know when you're in love? What do we always say? You just know, right? Because you feel it, right? Your heart beats a little bit faster. Your cheeks might flush. You get excited to see someone. But also, love can be between friends. When you want to do whatever you can to make someone else comfortable, to make someone have what they don't have, to share. So I want you to think about the different types of love that we experience in our life, but that it's not just a word. It's something that you feel. So let us think about that for a moment before we offer a word of prayer. Good and gracious God, you created us from love to love. And sometimes we forget this, because we get all wrapped up in our own selfish behaviors. We need to be reminded how deeply you love us in order to be able to love ourselves, so then we can in turn send that love out into the world. Help us be your love for those who need it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Are we ready for another song? Let's stand and let's sing together.
I felt it first when I was younger. Strange connection to the light. Try to satisfy the hunger. I never got it right. I never got it right. So I climbed a mountain, built an altar. Looked out as far as I could see. Every day I'm getting older. I'm running out of dreams. I'm running out. You're the song when my heart is singing. It's your love. You're the eyes to the blind man. You're the feet to the lame man walking. You're the sound of the people singing. It's your love.
Have a seat, and I want to get all of the kids' attention up here. I know I'd love to have you run up here, but we're going to wait just a little bit longer before we can do that. But I know some of y'all are here, and it's so great to see your faces, even from behind a mask. So I want to show you what I've got. I've got something to give you today. This is a bag tag. You can see on the screen what it looks like up close. It says, be loved, be kind, be you. And of course, on the back, my bag was blessed at First Lutheran Church. This is something that you can take with you through the school year to help you remember that you are loved by those who are here at First Lutheran Church. And I know this school year might be a scary time. You know, you might have to wear a mask when you're in your classroom and you can't see your teachers and your friends' smiling faces. And it's challenging maybe to hear somebody speak through a mask. But we do it because we care for you and want to keep you safe. And so I want you to remember that. When times get scary, look at your bag tag. Know that you are loved by a whole church, an entire church, whole bunch of people. They're loving you, they're rooting for you, and they're praying for you. But this is a message just for you to take into this year, to remember that you are loved, so be loved. That you are kind, so be kind. But above it all, be you. Because God created you perfectly, just the way you are. Nobody wants you to change. You are perfect exactly the way you are. So let us pray. God of fresh starts and new beginnings, we bring ourselves, our big feelings, and our backpacks to you. Last year was different from what we expected. We couldn't see our friends or play on playgrounds. We learned at home, in masks, 6 feet apart, or both. And in all these changes, we may have felt sad and alone. So God, our friend who comforts us, hold us close and wipe our tears. In our backpacks, we carry blank pages and sharpened pencils and pointy crayons. And in our hearts, we carry big feelings, unanswered questions, and hopeful expectations. There are endless possibilities of what this new year might bring, of what we might learn, who we might meet, and who we might become. And God, our friend, is always with us. So be with us as we ride the bus. Be with us, God, as we walk. Be with us as we buckle seatbelts, zip up jackets, and tie shoes. And however we get there and whatever we wear, bless this journey into something new. And for the grown-ups going back to school, be with them too. Thank you for our teachers, our helpers, caregivers and leaders, and for all that they do to help us learn and grow. God, our friend who's full of wonder, fill their hearts and bless their hands. Amen. After church, we'll make sure that you get one of these. And those of you at home would like one of these, we will have them in a basket right outside our front door. So you are welcome to come by this week and pick one up so your bag will be ready for school as well. Thanks.
Good morning. God, investigate my life. Get all the facts firsthand. I'm an open book to you, even from a distance. You know what I'm thinking. You know when I leave and when I get back. I'm never out of your sight. You know everything I'm going to say before I start the first sentence. I look behind me, and you're there. Then up ahead, and you're there too. Your reassuring presence coming and going. This is too much, too wonderful. I can't take it all in. Then I said to myself, Oh God, even sees me in the dark. At night, I'm immersed in the light. It's a fact. Darkness isn't dark to you. Night and day, darkness and light, they're all the same to you. Oh yes, you shaped me first inside, then out. You formed me in my mother's womb. I thank you, God, you're breathtaking. Body and soul, I am marvelously made. I worship in adoration. What a creation. You know me inside and out. You know every bone in my body. You know exactly how I was made, bit by bit. How I was sculpted from nothing into something. Like an open book. You watch me grow from conception to birth. All the stages of my life were spread out before you. The days of my life all prepared before I'd even lived. Your thoughts, how rare, how beautiful. God, I'll never comprehend them. I couldn't even begin to count them, any more than I could count the sand of the sea. Oh, let me rise in the morning and live always with you.
Thank you, Tom. When I was a kid, I had a long mirror on the back of my bedroom door. It was the kind that went from the top of the door all the way down, and it was the one that I used for that last-minute check before I ran out the door. But I can remember several times sitting on the floor in front of that mirror, staring, like really staring at myself, touching my arms, my legs, my hair, and my face, looking deep into my own eyes, sticking out my tongue, squishing up my nose, and trying to see inside my belly button. And I questioned, how am I alive? I couldn't fathom what it meant to be alive. Seriously, what does it mean? Like really living? What did alive mean? What did life mean? Who else is out there? Where was heaven? And what happened when you died? All these deep questions being pondered by a preteen in front of her mirror. And I wonder if any of you had some questions like that at one point in your life. As we get older and we go through school, we learn about how life is created and how babies are born. We learn about all the functions of the body and how everything works. We learn there are 206 bones in the body and that the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell. We learn about things that make us sick and things that will make us well again. And for me, it's hard to deny the existence of God when you've learned about all that. School textbooks and teachers help us to understand how we are made. But what we just heard, Psalm 139, now that's the text that connects us to our Creator. This psalm begins with reminding us as the reader how intimately God knows us. I'm an open book to you, the psalmist says. This is deep and profound knowledge of who we are personally. Not just the superficial person we are in front of everybody else, but who we are deep down in our core. God is not a distant observer, but a creator that knows its creations in the entirety of their existence like no one else. The psalmist continues by saying how God knows what we're going to say before we say it. Now, that could be a frightening thought, especially when you consider all the harmful and hurtful things that come out of our mouths. God knew that we were going to say that. And God loves us still. We are then told how God is in front of us and behind us. And that also might be a little scary for people. But the psalmist says how wonderful this is for us. And think about it. God is with us wherever we go. Whether it's to our jobs every day or as kids as we go to school, or if we travel to new places, or even in those dark and scary places of our lives, God is there. And then we get to a section that might just boggle the mind. God formed us within our mother's wombs. I remember in middle school science class seeing a video of all the dividing cells that are becoming an embryo. How rapidly it divided, creating life. And God was there, overseeing all of it, making sure there were blue eyes or black hair or dimples or intelligence or athletic ability or dancing skills. But also think about it like this. God created your kidneys, which remove toxins from your body, and big toes that we stub on furniture in the middle of the night, and that pesky sciatic nerve, right? The one that causes more pain than we'd like. God created that. And our spine that supports our back and our head, which holds our brain that runs it all. And your spleen. But I have no idea what that's for. But God does. And that's what's spectacular. God knows how it all works. I don't need to. And finally, this psalm ends by God describing God's thoughts as numerous as the grains of sand. Now, I want you to think about that. If you would just pick up one scoop of sand, how many grains are in that one scoop? I bet even if you tried, you could not count them all. And think about how many grains of sand are on every single beach over the entire earth. Unbelievable, right? And that's how many thoughts God has. It's amazing. So what's the big deal about this psalm, and why are we reading it today? Well, this is the perfect time to be reminded how wonderful each person is, especially those younger ones among us. This is a special time for them. A special time of year. Most of them are going to be heading back to school or have already started. This past year was so challenging, most of us can't even imagine. And now they're headed back to school. And for some of them, it's for the very first time since this pandemic started. We are not God who has known them since before they were born. But many of us have been there for these kids since the moments of their birth. You see, we celebrated with their families when they were born. We put little red roses on the altar to celebrate a birth. And we rejoiced with them when they were baptized, maybe right here at this font. And when that happened, we made promises to them as they grow. We're going to support them. And we say we're going to be 3A adults. And what does that mean? Authentic, affirming, and available. But should we only be 3A adults to those kids that come to our church? Not at all. We need to be available and authentic and affirming with every child we come in contact with. And the beginning of school is a perfect time to be reminded of this. But how are we to be a 3A adult to children everywhere? Well, we can begin with our prayers. Pray for our schools. Pray for our teachers and anyone who's going to interact with our children. And then we act. Go get to know your neighbors that have kids. Ask how you can support them this school year. We are called to nurture all children. The closest ones to us and the ones that are at such a distance will never see their faces. The God who has known us from our very beginning is the God who has watched us all along. God has seen our comings and goings, our faithfulness and our faithlessness. Yet God has remained present with us. Because God has known us, fully known us, we can trust in God when the world goes awry, like it did this past year. So take some time to celebrate the perfectly imperfect you. Amen. I know we've got another great song we're going to sing together, so let us prepare for that.
Join us in singing "You Already Know."
Completely unprepared, nothing.
Thank you. That song gets me every time. What a perfect song for the message today. Shoes. I'm going to talk about shoes. Bring your old shoes. We want to collect them. We're collecting them through October the 15th. Bring them in a bag. We've got a big collection area up at our front door. So please bring those. We've got a really good organization we're sending them to. So now's the perfect time. Clean out your closet and bring us all your old shoes. Good. Thank you for shoes, God. Now we settle our hearts and our minds, and we have a conversation with God. Let us pray. Good and gracious God, you have searched us and you know us. You have made all of creation in each cell of our bodies. You know our thoughts and you know our sins. We thank you and praise you that wherever we go, we can know that you will be there with us. We thank you that you guide us and hold us. And we pray for those who may continue to feel alone during this time of pandemic. May they sense your presence with them today. Remind us all how we are wonderfully and marvelously made when we forget that. Lord of the journey, show us the way. Creator of the world, we hold before you those threatened with wildfires across the North American continent, across Southeast Europe, and across North Africa. We pray for those who have lost everything, for those who offer everything in the fight to contain them, and for those neighborly souls who support them. We hold before you those threatened with unseasonable, unexpected heavy rain and floods, and for the multiple rescue agencies who make these their concerns. And we behold before you those threatened with drought, famine, and malnutrition, and for those who respond and give out of their abundance to help others survive. And today we specifically pray for those in Haiti dealing with the after effects of a devastating earthquake. Send them the helpers they need to recover as they continue to grieve. Lord of the journey, show us the way. Loving God, all of nature calls you blessed, and so do we. For you have woven an intimate tapestry, call it life, and said that it is good. In love, you have formed a universe so diverse yet so related, and into its web you call us forth to walk the land and swim the sea with all our sisters and brothers. To the stars, we seem no more than blades of grass. Yet to you, each of us, as each blade of grass and each star, is an irreplaceable treasure, an essential companion on this journey of love. Open our hearts to understand the intimate relationship that you have with all creation. Lord of the journey, show us the way. God of love, our days are sometimes filled with too much pain and violence and sorrow that we see and we experience. Some days it seems nearly impossible to see compassion and hope at work in the world. Use us to be that compassion and hope. We lift to you now those who have recently died. We pray for their families, John Armstrong, Keith Peterson, and Ray Wally. We also ask that you surround these people with your love and care as they are dealing with illness and recoveries. Howard and Rachel, Sam and Ron, Ellen, Sam, David, Julia, Charlene, Wanda, John, and Grace, Edgar, Corbin, Susan, Joanne, Bob, Shannon, Kate, Cindy, Will, Judy, John, Sarah, Marilyn. And we lift to you those we personally know by saying their names out loud or silently. God of healing, gently touch these lives with your spirit. Bring warmth and comfort, restoration into their fractured lives and souls. Lord of the journey, show us the way. We pray now together the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We have come to the portion of our service where we celebrate communion. Hopefully you picked up a little cup that has your wafer and juice in it. If not, it's right at the front door when you came in. Those of you at home, I hope you have something in which you can eat and drink as we share this sacrament together. Please join me in the words for communion. Coming together as people who, though we are not alike, are all together, like our prayers are linked together in a tapestry of many colors. That is what we come to this table to take in, along with this bread and wine, the amazing life-giving truth that through Christ's love and grace, there is no other, there is only us, and we are all welcomed and loved. We remember how Jesus first celebrated this meal of bread and wine with his disciples. It was a night like we have often had when we gather at a table with friends and family or strangers, when we try to connect and we're misunderstood, when we reach out and get hurt, when what we do as an act of love isn't taken the right way. In the midst of that moment, Jesus took a piece of bread and a cup of wine and blessed it and said, "Do this to remember me," wanting us to know that it is in this very human act of eating and drinking and sitting together at a table that God is with us, that it is in the daily acts of living our lives that Christ is seen and known and experienced. This is where the hope of the world is. This is what love looks like. These messy, imperfect moments of being together. Remember, this is given in love for you. Once you have replaced your mask, please stand with me for our final blessing and song. In front of us, behind us, to our right, to our left, look, God is there. In our past, beside us today, waiting in the future, look, God is there. In the shadows, in the light, look, God is there. From the top of the mountains to the bottom of the seas, God is there. In the morning, in the evening, in every moment, God is there. We will live every moment knowing God is always with us. Amen.
Join us in singing Even Then.
Heart beats a little bit deeper.
Thank you so much for those of you that have been worshiping with us at home. Be sure that you come by and get your bag tags this week at some point. They'll be at the front door. Thank you to all of you who have been here in person today. It's been great to see you all. And now go with Christ and go as Christ to love and serve God's world. Thanks be to God.